Welcome back to free engineering tutorial on operating system. So in this video we are going to start new chapter which is known as file system. Okay, so in this chapter we will discuss totally about files. So what are files? So these are simply a physical storage area where we are storing a sensible data. Okay, so the data which is making any sense or related data. So this related data is called information. And to store information, we need some area which is known as files. Okay, so all the study of files we will discuss in file systems. So file system consists of two parts. Okay, so there are two types of files. One which really consists of information. Okay, so like txt files. Okay, text files, these contain data. Okay, and the other way around is that there is one other type of file which is known as folder. Okay, so folder means it is directory. It will contain the different files or information about files. Okay, so this comprises of the second classification of file system, which is known as directory structure, where it is organizing and provides information about all the files. Okay, so one which is giving the information about all the files is known as file systems, the second classification. Okay, so in this slide, as you can see that I had given the glimpse of what is file. So let's read it quickly. A file is named collection of related information that is recorded on secondary storage. Okay, so this related information is the key concept. Okay, after that, information in a file is defined by its creator. Okay, so the programmer will not define what is the information consisting in file. Okay, the creator will define what is the information should be stored in file. A file has a custom defined structure which depends on its type. Okay, so the text type will have different structure. Binary file will contain different structure. Okay, executable file is a series of code sections that the loader can bring into memory and execute. Okay, so these are executable files which can load into the memory and it will generate any output. Okay, so it will contain code lines. After that, there are some file attributes. So like majorly there are six attributes for any file. So first one is the name of the file. Second one is that what is the size of the file. After that, we are providing one specific ID to each and every file. So it will be the third attribute of the file. After that, what is the type of protection? So some files are write protected for some users. Okay, so for any user which belong to any word class or word group, so we have to protect him from executing the file. Okay, so this is a type of protection. So we have to specify what are the types of protection which is being implemented on file. Okay, after that, what is the location of the file where it is being stored in disk. After that, what is the time date for which it is being modified. Okay, and what is the user ID which who had made the file. Okay, after that, there are certain file operations also. So these are simple operations like firstly creating a file. Okay, after that, one who is using a file. So this is the file operation in which we can use a file. Okay, after that, reading a file. Okay, so when we are reading means taking the inputs from the file and just reading. Okay, so this is reading a file. After that, repositioning within a file. Okay, so if we have to reposition some amount of text from line number 23, say, and have to copy to line number 46. Okay, so this is repositioning within a file. Okay, after that, deleting a file. Okay, so deleting a file means fully delete the file from the disk. Okay, after that, truncating a file. Truncating a file means if the file is already stored in anywhere on the disk, we are just making erasing all the contents of file which are already there, and we are starting or writing the file from the new beginning. Okay, so in new operating system, to avoid searching, an open system call is made. So there is an API, open system call is made before a file is used. Okay, So when we are using open function, it will keep the track that we which and all are the files which are open at any instant of time. The OS keeps a small table called the open file table. Okay, so it will store all the information of the files which are being open at any instant of time. After that, what are internal tables? Okay, so there are two type of internal tables which are being executed or which are being made by operating system. So first one is that per process table, after that system wide table. So while taking analogy, per process table simply means a guard which is putting or maintaining a register. Okay, so this register is called per process table. So any guard which is on the entrance of any apartment and is writing all the information of all the people and visitors who are coming inside the apartment. So this will be the per process table. Okay, and the other one is system wide table. Okay, so what it will do is that if a process calls open, okay, simply if a process is coming, means opening a file, so it will store the it will be stored in system wide table. Okay, so what and all are the calls which are being made by this process. Okay, this process, firstly it will call open. Okay, so it will be stored in system wide table. After that, if let's say there is any other process which is calling open. Okay, it is also calling open, so it will be stored in this, okay, per process table. So it will store P1 and it will store P2. Okay, so in this way it will store the information about all the process which are opening any file. After that, if we are if any process calls close function, okay, so it will decrease the pointer by 1. Okay, so let's say P2 calls close. Okay, so it will be deleted from this per process table. Okay, simple as that. After that, files information. Okay, so there are three type of file information majorly. So one is, where is the file pointer? So there is one file pointer which is used for writing and reading, and the other attribute, or we can say the information of file, is that file count. Okay, so what is the count of the file? After that, disk location of file. So where the file is really situated on the disk. Okay, so these are the three information which are there privately to any file. Okay, so if a file is there, so firstly it have to keep track of, means keep the information of where the pointer is stored, what is the count of the file, and where it is located in disk. Okay, so these are the three informations. And as we know, if the different files can be opened by different processes, we have to keep track of what are the logs behind every process. Okay, so first one is shared log. Okay, so shared log is just like reader's log. Any process can acquire the log concurrently. Okay, so concurrently logs are being made, so this is coming under shared log. After that, exclusive log means it is just analogical to writer log. Only one process at a time can acquire the log. Okay, so if one process is accessing the file, no other process can access this file which is being logged by this one process. Okay, so there are other file logs also. So one is, two type of locking mechanisms are deployed in operating system. One is advisory. Okay, so on the advice of programmer, the logs are being made or implemented on any file. And the other one is mandatory. So if one process has logged some resources, no other process can access those resources. Okay, so one is, on the advice of programmer, logs are implemented. The other way is, if the log is being implemented, no other process can access those resources. So this all comprises of the basics of file system. Okay, So in next video we will discuss file structures. Okay, so before that there is one other topic, file types. So for different file types, like there are txt files. Okay, so we have name of the file, let's say a.txt. so this is the name and this is the extension, that's all. Okay, so these are different types of files. If we'll change this extension, so this is known as extension. So if we will discuss means it at the changing of txt by .obj, so this is different file type. Okay, and if we'll change the name, then it will be the different file. Okay, so okay, then in next video we will discuss file structure. Till then, thank you.